This is unquestionably, I should say, a boycott-affected event. You can see that the Olympic and world records are both held by Petra Schneider of the German Democratic Republic. Schneider has been passed in the German rankings, or the East German rankings, I should say, by Kathleen Nord, who might have ranked as the favorite to win the gold medal in this event, except that you must point out that Tracy Calkins defeated Kathleen Nord earlier this year in their one recent head-to-head meeting, and it is Calkins and not Nord who ranks number one in the world this year. So perhaps Tracy would have been favored anyway. Now let's quickly look at the rest of the field. In lane one, 18-year-old Gaylor Stanley of Great Britain, her strongest stroke is the breaststroke. Remember, they will swim butterfly, then backstroke, then breaststroke, then freestyle, 100 meters of each. Lane two, Katrina Bomstad of Larvik, Norway, trained in this country for much of last year, Yeho Swim Club. Not as fast, though, as some might have expected her to swim in the qualifying trials. Lane three, big surprise, Natalie Gingras. The surprise of the trials, qualified third behind Calkins and Sue Heon of the United States. Ranked only 22nd in the world last year, but here she is in an Olympic final and in lane three with a chance to win a medal. Lane four is the woman who has won 51 national swimming titles, broken American records 61 times, is the 1978 world champion in this event as well as two other individual events, and one of the very few women to win the Sullivan Award as this nation's outstanding amateur athlete. She was given that award after her memorable performance at the World Championships in 1978. That was Tracy Calkins. Now in lane five next to her, and the favorite to win the silver medal, is 22-year-old Sue Heon of Clark's Summit, Pennsylvania, who has bettered her previous personal record by more than 3 seconds this year and ranks third in the world behind Calkins and Nord in 1984. Lane six, Petra Zinder of the Federal Republic of Germany, third at the European Championships last summer behind Nord and Schneider of the German Democratic Republic. Big improvement in 1983 for Petra Zinder. Lane 7, Donna McGinnis of Canada. The Canadian swimmers, as well as the Australian swimmers, appear to have come to this meet particularly well prepared. Donna McGinnis, 15 years old, looked to be Canada's top medal hope in this event coming in. And lane 8, Suzanne Landell, 19 years old from Brisbane, Australia. Appeared to be one of Australia's top medal hopes in women's swimming coming in, but she did not swim as well as her coaches might have expected this morning. She'll hope to come back with a big effort here. There is Tracy Calkins, center stage, ready for what must rank as the most important race of her life to this point.
I'd say so, Jim, because even though she's qualified for three events, the 200-meter individual medley and the 100-meter breaststroke, she respects this race the most because it's 400 meters, it requires versatility, and I equate it to the decathlon of track. You must be able to be proficient in all four strokes, which she is, and most medley swimmers aren't. Usually they have one weak spot.
Few people know better than Donna Deverona, who was the first woman to win the Olympic gold medal in this event back in 1964. There's a false start. As you can see, that the nerves continue to dwell with all of these swimmers.
I might have chosen that option myself, Jim. I remember in Tokyo that I did false start during right before my Olympic race because I didn't feel right at that moment. I had waited in that waiting room and I just didn't feel good. I had to get my concentration back.
There is very little competitive suspense here. For Tracy Calkins to lose this race would be the biggest upset of this swimming competition. So in all likelihood, she will swim without close competition. That has been her custom throughout her career here in the United States and quite often in international competition. The last 28 times that she has swum the 400-meter individual medley in major meets, she's won 25 of them, and no American woman has beaten her in this event for many, many, many years.
I'm sure if she'd had those close races that she would have been closer to world standard time. But you need that fire of competition, especially if you're a competitor like Tracy.
Take care, Mark.
Now they go into the pool. Once again, butterfly, backstroke, breaststroke, and freestyle. 100 meters of each, and already Tracy Calkins has assumed almost a full body length lead. It's been a long time coming. If you were with us this morning during qualifying, you heard me say, but it bears repeating, I know of no other athlete whom I know personally who was so devastated, so disappointed by the boycott of 1980. And I'm not sure Tracy believed at that time that she would have the capability of making it back to these Olympic Games. Her body changed, her attitude towards swimming changed, but she came back.
Nancy Hogg said as well, you've seen two women that have hung in there longer and an age difference in our women's swimming unparalleled in modern swimming history. Of course, that's been possible because of college scholarships. Both Hogshead and Coughlin's did benefit from that option, which was not available until the 1970s, middle 1970s. You can see now she's swimming a very easy butterfly, breathing every other stroke. Fabulous undulation in her butterfly. She is.
She touched in 103.63, Donna. That's almost a full second behind the world record pace. But once again, she's swimming alone in the middle of the pool as she goes into the backstroke. She's good in all the strokes, right, Donna? Is there one
she
you
is.
Can say that's best?
She is. She did tell me earlier she wanted to be a second faster in the butterfly because she was thinking she wanted to swim under 4:40. She does have a best stroke, and I would say it is her breaststroke. However, at the Olympic trials, we saw that Tracy tried to qualify for six races. She wound up qualifying for three individual races, and that was basically because I think she tried too big of a program. She even admitted to me later that perhaps she had been too ambitious, and she was relieved that she had three events, possibly four if she wins the 100-meter breaststroke or is the top women 100-meter swimmer. But she has been able to get the rhythm in her breaststroke back. That was the big problem with the Olympic trials. And to credit to our coaches, her coaches, Paul Bergen and Randy Reese, who both coached her, they put their heads together during the trials and helped her make an adjustment in her stroke.
Now, we don't want to ignore the rest of the field and the battle for the silver medal, because certainly Soo Hee-an is a story there. And as they come down to the 200-meter mark, switching to the breaststroke leg, Hee-an is right in there. She is battling with Natalie Gingra of Canada. And at 2:14.74 for the 200-meter split, Hawkins is ahead of her American record pace. Check it, I mean 2:13.91, 2:14.74, the previous American record pace. She's ahead of it, Donna.
That's right, she's a second off the world record pace, but she said she wanted to push her breaststroke. She said she wanted to go 3 seconds faster than she did this morning, which would put her on world record time.
And just of course, to bring, go right ahead.
I wanted to talk about Soo Hee-an, who qualified second on the second place for the Olympic team. Quite a competitor, came down 3 seconds during the Olympic trials to make this team. She's fourth on the bottom of the screen. Her strongest stroke is the breaststroke and the freestyle. She was expected to be behind the rest of the field in the first two legs.
But Hee-an is in second place right now and in strong contention for the possible bronze medal. Now Petra Zender of the Federal Republic of Germany has moved up to threaten Hee-an. And as they come down to touch at the 300-meter mark, Hawkins' American record pace at that point would be 3:36.27. She touches in 3:34.81, so she's well ahead of her American record pace and about to leave a little bit of a landmark here for herself. If you had forgotten, it bears repeating. In 1976, the last time American women entered an Olympic pool in Montreal, they did not win a single individual event. In 1978 at the World Championship, they turned that around and won nine events against strong East German competition. The ringleader was this woman, Tracy Hawkins. She reestablished the self-esteem of American women swimmers in a pool in Berlin 6 years ago. And now she's swimming for her own self-esteem.
And that's why she was voted team captain, a leader that every one of her team members recognized. And if she can bring this baby home, she'll get her American record. I don't know how fast she's swimming right now. Pushing for the world record, I know.
4:40.61 is her American record. If she goes under 4:40, this will be a remarkable accomplishment for her. She's coming down to the wall. You see the world record on the left. Very hard to threaten that with no competition, but she broke her American record. She broke it by more than a full second. And that is going to bring a satisfied smile, I'm sure, to the face of Tracy Hawkins. Hee-an was touched out for second place. As second place went to Landells of Australia, and Soo Hee-an just barely missed the bronze. She wound up fourth. But Tracy Hawkins has finally won her first Olympic gold medal.
Tracy's